Let us join in the call to worship. Your love calls us here, gracious one, calling us to dine with you and to be instruments of your love. Let us join in our opening hymn, number 623.
Taste of fresh the calm. Our scripture lesson this evening is found in the book of John. And this scripture is Jesus washing the disciples' feet. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but it is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him, and for this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them." When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." Amen.
Let us pray. Your love calls us here, gracious one, calling us to dine with you and to be instruments of your love. Gather us now in Jesus' name, that we may offer him the full measure of our devotion. Amen. Hear the words of assurance. The Lord is the cup of our salvation. All who call on the name of the Lord will be saved.
We thank our choir for that beautiful anthem this evening. At this time, we ask our ushers to come forward that we may receive our offering. Let us pray. O source of love and compassion, you fill us with a deep spiritual longing to taste the cup of salvation and know the joys of servant ministry. We offer you tonight our very selves and the gifts we bring before you now, that we may fulfill your law of love and be a blessing to the world. Amen. Seated this evening for our second hymn, number 620.
Oh,
invitation to Holy Communion. Our souls hunger for food that satisfies. Our spirits long for the bread of heaven. Our souls are dry and parched from thirst. Our spirits yearn for the cup of salvation.
Please join with me in the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Come to the mountain of the Lord.
We come to see God's glory.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of all things in heaven and on earth. When the earth was formless and void, you brought your light into the darkness and order to the primordial chaos. From mere clay you fashioned us in your image and breathed into our lifeless bodies the breath of your life-giving spirit. When we wandered off and lost our way, you sent prophets and teachers to show us where we had gone astray. In the fullness of time, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to become living water and heavenly food for our very souls. Even at the moment of his darkest hour, when the forces of darkness conspired to end his life, and his disciples were about to fall away, Jesus offered himself as the bread of heaven and the cup of our salvation. And even when we fall away today, Christ continues to be for us the bread of heaven and the cup of our salvation. And so, with your people on earth, and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn, saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is the bread of heaven, Christ Jesus. When you sent Christ to be with us, he offered his very self that we might have the strength to stand when all hope seems lost. Through the holy mystery of this table, we are invited into your presence, tended to in our brokenness and strengthened in our weakness. With joy and gratitude, remember that night in which Jesus took bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is the bread of life given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts of love and grace, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as your covenant of people in unison with Christ's Spirit, and as reflections of your glory, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Let us pray. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us, that we may be servants of others, even as Jesus was a servant to his disciples. Pour out your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be for us the life and love of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by your gracious love. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other and one in ministry to the world. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. At this time, we would ask our ushers to direct you to the front that we may receive Holy Communion. Let us now join in our closing hymn, number 617.
Each proud division ends.
pray together the benediction. Blessed by God, we are called to live. Fed by Christ, we are called to serve. To free us from the cycle of hatred and violence, God offers us the promise of love, the promise of a godly future. Go forth now and love one another well. Amen.